Hey there, ladies and gentlemen. Today I am bringing you a little cup box roulette battle against mesoqt of Pokemon Showdown. I found him through the Pokemon Showdown Wi-Fi room, which anyone who's gone in that room knows is like 90% people asking for trades or for free Pokemon. So how do you get a battle in a room like that? Well, one way to do it is to offer free Pokemon. I literally posted, anyone up for a little cup box roulette battle, I provide the Pokemon and you get to keep them. And so, yes, you get six free battle-ready little cup Pokemon that you can then use for whatever purposes you want. All you have to do is battle me. And so I got to take her pretty much immediately. So the team that I generated for him is actually decently competitive, except for the fact that he's got three ground-type Pokemon, all three of which natively know Stealth Rock. I told him that he should probably put Swords Dance on his... on one of the two, either Edgar Rice or on Drillbur. But on my end, I actually got no Pokemon that can take advantage of the fact that he's like all ground. Instead, I got a two Pokemon that are weak to ground. But I'm at least getting to try out some new breeds that I've done, or at least some modifications I've done. So, he goes ahead and sets up Stealth Rock. That's what I was expecting him to do, and so that's fine. That's why I went out into my Baltoy, because I figured that I could spin him away. Instead, I decided I would just want to take him out with Ice Beam. I don't take him out with Ice Beam, and he's able to knock off my Aviolite. I'm actually not sure if that was min damage. Sandshrew is impish and runs a decent... well... so Impish is plus defense, actually. So the point is it's bulky. So, and Baltoy is weak as anything. So I go for Rapid Spin here, hoping to get the Rapid Spin KO. I don't because he switches out, but at least I get the Rocks gone, which is really nice because I have a few Pokemon that really prefer to be able to go in at full HP. So here I'm expecting him to Scald because this is my bold Chinchou set. I know that it's only my Sleep Talk set, and I know that the only attacking move it has is Scald, and I'm fishing for the burn here. Ikoria would love, love, love to be burned because it's got Guts. So I go for the bulk up thinking he might switch out. He does not, and he goes for Scald again, and I'm like, this is now the third Scald, and nothing got the burn. I'm like, that's so lame. So here I go for the Drain Punch. And it does about half, and that's great, because I know that I can take another Scald. And I'm hoping that this one will finally be the one to burn me. And instead he gets a crit. Okay. Lame. Lame, 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 lame. And I've lost my Timber, and that's really sad. And I was so phased by that loss that I did the stupidest switch... and did the stupidest move. I completely forgot about Volt Absorb, and I go for the Volt Switch here. Now, it turns out that my opponent decided to take advantage of my... or didn't realize that I was going to be that stupid, and sent out his Drillbur. Drillbur, by the way, I believe can bypass Sturdy thanks to Mold Breaker, so I have to switch out into something. Mind Foo might not have been the best switch in retrospect. So here... there's a correct move that I could have made, and I don't make it. Plus 2 EQ from this Drillbur is going to manage to take out River. I will let you know whether that was a max damage roll. I don't think it was. It might not have been a guaranteed KO, but it was probably close. And so now I'm just hoping that I can survive a plus 2 Rock Slide. And I can't. It was a crit. I'm not sure whether the crit mattered. I will let you know. And so now half of my team is gone. And I'm going to go out into Emily here. So now, ordinarily, this would be a dead Drifloon, but a few things. Number one, he missed. Number two, I carry Focus Sash instead of the Berry Juice item that I originally put on this. So that means I'm going to be able to survive. That's why I really need those rocks gone. I hang on with Focus Sash, and now I'm unburdened and faster than anything. But it doesn't actually matter, because he's got that Diglett, and Diglett carries Sucker Punch. So, yeah, except for he doesn't send out his Diglett, because he doesn't realize this. So this is an advantage that I have in all of these battles, which is I know these sets really well because I made them, and even though I give my opponent the opportunity to look over the sets, they haven't necessarily used them in battle before, so they don't necessarily know the capabilities here. So he's now sent out two Pokemon that are not Diglett. I go for the Acrobatics, I get a crit, but it's not enough to KO, which is sad. It's very sad, because he's going to recover back up to almost almost full HP with that berry juice, and now is going to get behind a sub, and now, so the best I can do is break his sub and force him to kill me. But yeah, had he gotten out into Diglett, I would not have been able to take out the two Pokemon that I did. So, you know, that was kind of, we both did the exact same mistake. We both had Pokemon that could counter the Pokemon that was out, and instead we both sacrificed, he sacrificed one Pokemon, I sacrificed two, due to being stupid. Anyway, he goes ahead and Night Slashes here. Considering he hasn't gotten any superpowers up, I'm thinking this should be okay. I survive it quite well. I go for the Iron Head, followed by a Shadow Sneak that is going to take out I, and that's great, because now I don't have to worry about it destroying my team. Instead, I have to worry about the fact that Diglett is going to destroy my team. So out now is going to be Diglett. I don't think I can take an EQ, so I go for the Shadow Sneak. To at least get damage off of it, break its sash. He goes for the Rock Tomb! That was very surprising. And so now I'm thinking, well, he's probably going to go for, he's almost certainly going to go for the Sucker Punch here. So I decided I'm going to do some, I think I went for the Swords Dance. But it doesn't matter, he takes me out and with an Earthquake because he just decided that was a smart thing to do. But had I gone for another Shadow Sneak, I would have actually been able to KO. So that's too bad. So here, Heterodyne is my last best hope. Not best hope, worst hope, because I can't do anything to Chinchou. So, I survive with Sturdy, gonna go back up to full HP with Berry Juice. This is a really, really annoying set that was commissioned, I am back up to full HP, and I've got, and you're gonna see in a second, why this is such an annoying set. So you think, oh, well, he's used up his Berry Juice, that's fine. So it's going to take him a few hits, but it'll be to KO, but it's still fine. Goes ahead and goes for the Hydro Pump here, gets me down to 4, and I go for Recycle. So I'm going to get that Berry Juice right back. People have been talking about banning Recycle for this very reason, that it is annoying as heck. But as you are going to see in a minute, it's not really very broken, because you just need the Pokemon that can wall Magnemite, and it's fine. So, I go again for a Recycle, and basically I am fishing for a Hydro Pump miss. Hydro Pump does not have 100% accuracy, so this is a good play on my part. Recycle actually has decent PP too, so he's going to go ahead and switch out here, realizing, look, it's time to switch out, this is not going to work. And he sends out Chinchou, and I go for the Recycle again, so now I've got Berry Juice, and I'm at full HP, so I go for the Flash Cannon, which is the only move that I can use against this guy. And I'm like, I guess I'm fishing for the special defense drop, but it doesn't matter because he's got the Rest Talk. I mean, I know this is Rest Talk set, so he's going to go be back up to full HP. He can stall me out forever. Even if I manage to get 6 special defense drops, there's no way I'm taking out this Chinchou. And at some point, he's going to scald me, and he's going to get the burn, and that's going to ruin my entire strategy 100%. So I actually take that. It doesn't get the burn. Still not getting the burn. It's like this, something's weird's going on with the RNG, and it like forgot that that Scald could burn. So here I'm thinking, okay, he's probably going to burn the next turn, and that's going to suck, and it's going to kill me. But there's nothing I can do. So Angler's fast asleep. Actually, there is something I could do. The fourth move on the set is Endure, and so if I were to go for Endure, I would be back at the full with the Berry Juice, but it doesn't matter. He gets the max damage on the Scald and KOs me, and that's fine. Folks, I hope you enjoyed this battle. Comment, rate, subscribe, and challenge. So long.